By about high school, I knew that I wanted to do something in physics. I knew that MIT would be a great place for that. And I had heard about how undergrads could do research.
Prashanth is extremely smart, extremely motivated. One of the key things undergraduates bring to the table is a fresh perspective, a willingness to essentially try things that sometimes, as sort of a seasoned researcher, you sort of overlook. You think you know what the answer is going to be. You let hubris essentially take over. And you don't explore things that sometimes undergraduates do. And sometimes they hit the jackpot. So what is this? What are we looking at?
These are the plots of the average flux with respect to frequency. And just for your convenience, I showed what I've been doing is to model one particular type of a new class of structures called photonic crystals.
What is a photonic crystal? Well, it's a periodic structure with features where the periodicity of the structure is on the wavelength of light.
I'm studying what frequencies and wavelengths of light are emitted the most when parts of the crystal are excited. Here, there are two very distinct peaks where the energy emitted is much higher for those ranges of frequency.
The importance of that work is that a lot of these fluorescent molecules are being used to do spectroscopy or to monitor cells or microscopic and nanoscopic objects. This is essentially your unit cell size, you know, lambda. So for example, one might think of essentially piggybacking one of these molecules in a tumor cell and imaging essentially the behavior of the tumor cell as a function of time or as a function of space.
I mean, if it's Lorentzian, it seems fairly straightforward, right?
Yeah.
Research is not limited to postdocs and grad students. Undergrads can do it too. And often they contribute a very vital role in some of the research that goes on.
And this is basically tangentially, like the light is essentially. I was an undergraduate here. One of the reasons I came to MIT was actually because of the UROP program. Once you find what you're really interested in and what you want to do, you can continue doing that, and that can eventually develop into your graduate program. I wouldn't be where I am today, actually, if it weren't for the UROP program.